In the first 10 episodes of series 1, we have proven the true God of the Gita is the three-eyed Shiv Shankar through the Gita verses. We have also proven in episode 11, part 1 and 2, that the universal God Shiv Shankar is the God mentioned in the Quran and the Bible too. And in episode 12, we have proven that the belief of no rebirth in Islam and Christianity is a misinterpretation by the scholars. In the current episode, we will present the references related to dharma and adharma in the Bible, which is the righteousness of heaven and the unrighteousness in hell, respectively. We introduced these color codes in series 1 in a logical fashion. We request the viewers to make note of these color codes while going through the notes mentioned on the screen that are coded with these color codes. One may find an additional green color coded words. The mystery of this green personality is elaborately revealed in series 3 with a variety of evidences from all world cultures. Let us look at the Bible references that give the definitions of righteousness and unrighteousness of heaven and hell, which are metaphorized as day and night. This reference from Matthew mentions, "Happy are those conscious of their spiritual need, since the kingdom of the heavens belongs to them." The reference from Ephesians mentions, "Therefore, become imitators of God as beloved children." The imitators of God are the gods and goddesses, and their divine qualities are mentioned as Daivi Sampada in Gita verses 1 to 3 of chapter 16. This verse from Ephesians mentions, "For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth." The Gita verse 45 from chapter 2 mentions Nitya Sattvastha and Atmavan, meaning the true qualities of righteousness and the soul consciousness. The word religion of soul is called as Swadharma in Sanskrit, as mentioned in 35 of 3 in the Gita, also explained in episode 3 of series 1. The verse from Romans mentions, "For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am fleshly, sold under sin." The Gita verse 63 of chapter 2 mentions about fleshly, which is the period of grave, with dead mankind or dead intellect, the dead soul. Soul itself is mind and intellect. When it is filled with falsehood, under the influence of the divided religions of the world, called the seven sins, the seven plagues, this period of grave in the Gita is called the mortal world, the hell, which is the period of pain and sorrows. We have analyzed the word human being in episode 3, wherein we said humus is the flesh, the body consciousness, and the being is the spirit. When the soul indulges in the awareness of soul, that is called law of spirit, and when the soul indulges in the bodily desires, Bible mentions it as fleshly or the blood, which leads to sinful actions. The next verse from Ezekiel mentions, "And you will have to know that I am Yehovah when I open your graves and when I raise you up out of your graves, O my people." The word grave has been explained in episode 11, part 2, with Bible references, which is dead intellect people in the hell. By the end of Iron Age, everybody becomes dead intellect, and Yehovah comes to enlighten the intellect with his light of knowledge. Please watch series 1, episode 4, 5, and 11, part 2, for a complete clarity on the above verses from Bible. This verse from Corinthians mentions, "By purity, by knowledge, by patience, by kindness, by Holy Spirit, by love free from hypocrisy, by truthful speech, by God's power, through the weapons of righteousness." And what agreement does God's temple have with idols? For we are a temple of a living God. Just as God said, I will reside among them and walk among them, and I will be their God, and they will be my people. Therefore, get out from among them and separate yourselves, says Yehovah, and quit touching the unclean thing, and I will take you in. And I will become a father to you, and you will become sons and daughters to me, says Yehovah the Almighty. We have understood from episode 11, part 2, that Yehovah creates Adam and makes him the Almighty. The enlightened Adam then creates the heaven and the hell on the earth. Thus, the words are appropriately colored. And the word God's temple is also explained in that episode 11, part 2, wherein the temple is the body of Adam, Arjuna, in which the Yehovah, the Holy Spirit, the one who never takes birth, has self-manifested. And thus he becomes a living God through the temple, the bodily temple of Adam. Thus it is said, we, because in that bodily temple there are two souls. And the father to all the people is, in fact, Adam, because Yehovah's only begotten son is Adam alone. Hence, the we is a combination of the Supreme Father and the Father of all mankind. The next verse from 2 Corinthians mentions, therefore, since we have these promises, beloved ones, let us cleanse ourselves of every defilement of flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. Now, here, we is the combination of the two souls in one body of Adam. And the next sentence mentions, let us cleanse ourselves. This is being said by Adam because Yehovah is a holy spirit. He doesn't need to clean. But the one inside that temple, who will be becoming the God, the Almighty, Adam, through the knowledge of Yehovah, also needs to cleanse himself. Plus, he has to cleanse all those who recognize the two souls in one body, the Shiva Shankar, and thereby are making the spiritual effort to imbibe the knowledge in their soul, that is spirit, and to control all the bodily desires that cause sinful actions, thus perfecting in the image of God to become gods and goddesses who will be part of the heaven. Thus, Adam's body is the temple or chariot of God, as covered in episode 11, part 2. The Gita verse 37 of 3 mentions about impure vice of lust, which is the enemy of man, which keeps him away from becoming enlightened with the light of Yehovah's knowledge. And the verse 11 of 7 mentions about righteous, pure spouses of heaven, because in heaven people are aware of soul alone, they are unaware of their body. Hence, during the end of the Iron Age, when Yehovah comes, evil habits of bodily desires have to be unlearned and the spiritual habits have to be incorporated. Here is a verse from Bible that mentions the list of divine virtues and the demonic vices, which are almost in line with the first three Gita verses in chapter 16 that are covered in our episode 2 to 5 in series 1. This verse from Colossians mentions, deaden therefore your body members that are on the earth as respects sexual immorality, uncleanliness, uncontrolled sexual passion, hurtful desire, and greediness, which is idolatry. Make a note that sexual immorality is incorrect because once we become the sons and daughters of Yehovah, the sexual relationship has to be completely avoided. Therefore, the term immorality does not arise. And all the desires of the body have been termed here as idolatry. On account of those things, the wrath of God is coming. That is how you two used to conduct yourself in your former way of life. But now you must put them away from you wrath, anger, badness, abusive speech, and obscene talk out of your mouth. Do not lie to one another. Strip off the old personality with its practices and clothe yourself with the new personality, which through accurate knowledge is being made new according to the image of the one who created it. Where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, foreigner, Scythian, slave, or freeman. Accordingly, as God's chosen ones, holy and loved, clothe yourself with the tender affections of compassion, kindness, humility, mildness, and patience. Continue putting up with one another and forgive one another freely, even if anyone has a cause for complaint against another. Just as Yehovah freely forgave you, you must also do the same. But besides all these things, clothe yourself with love, for it is perfect bond of union. Let us look at a verse from Bible which indicates the time of establishing dharma, that is heaven, which is at the end of hell. The reference from Daniel mentions, in the days of those kings, the God of heaven will set up a kingdom that will never be destroyed, and this kingdom will not be passed to any other people. It will crush and put an end to all these kingdoms, and it alone will stand forever. Just as you saw that out of the mountain a stone was cut, not by hands, and that it crushed the iron, the copper, the clay, the silver, and the gold. The grand God has made known to the king what will happen in the future. The dream is true and its interpretation is trustworthy. As said in Gita verse 7 of 4, God mentions that I come at the peak of unrighteousness, that is the divided world of heaven with many religions and kingdoms, to establish righteousness of one kingdom. And in 8 of 4, he mentions, I safeguard the righteous effort makers and kill the evildoers who do not desire to become righteous. In the days of those kings means when all the kingdoms of all religions are present on earth, that is at the end of the Iron Age. The grand God, Yehovah, made known to the king of earth and heaven is Adam. So he is given the knowledge of setting up the heaven by the grand God. As discussed about the three worlds in the series 1 of 8, the iron and copper is the period of Asuraloka, the hell, the night of falsehood, and the silver and gold are the Devaloka, the heaven or the day. The clay or the stone intellect period is the Brahmaloka, when the earthly, meaning the body conscious human beings, intellect like parts or the stones are recreated or recarved by the Param Brahma, meaning the duality of Shiva and Shankara, meaning Yehovah and Adam, as proven in series 1, the first 10 episodes. In series 3, we have presented the evidences on how the stone is cut and how the kingdoms are crushed through the Tanakh verses. Also, we have mentioned the evidences that the word God is incorrect translation for the Supreme. As per the Jewish Tanakh, the ancient Abrahamic scripture, the parent scripture from which the Bible descended. Now let us look at certain information from Wiki and the Bible which prove that the perfected Adam, the Shiv Shankar, is Noah. From the Hebrew name Noach, meaning rest, repose, which is derived from the root Nuash. According to the Old Testament, Noah was the builder of the ark that allowed him, his family, and animals of each species to survive the great flood. After the flood, he received the sign of the rainbow as a covenant from God. He was the father of Shem, Ham, and Yepeth. The four, that is the father Adam, the Shem, Ham, and Yepeth, the four people are the four religious fathers of the major religions of this world, namely the Adi Sanatana Devi Devata Dharma, which today is degraded and is called the Hinduism, and the Islam, Buddhism, and Christianity. The four, the Noah, the Shem, the Ham, and the Yepeth, are shown as four horses in the Gita, Greek, Roman, Islamic, Persian, etc., chariot driver and charioteer images, with the Supreme Soul Son, the Light of Wisdom, as the chariot driver, and the bodily chariot, the bodily temple of the Supreme Soul Intellect, the Wisdom, being Adam, Shankara, Arjuna. The word Nova in Sanskrit is nau, which means ship, boat, ark. The definition of Nova is like that of Shankar Chap Jahaj, as below. Shankar Chap Jahaj Jehi Chade Uttar Paranar Budh Sakal Sansar. Translated in English, it would be one who has taken support of that ship or has caught hold of it. The ship here is the bodily ship of Adam. When we catch hold of that bodily ship, we go to heaven because Yehovah is in that ship. And through the knowledge gained from the Adam, one becomes righteous. So one who has caught hold of it will go beyond this ocean-like world. If he gets lost somewhere and if he leaves the support of this ship and takes the support of some other small boat, then it is possible that he may drown. The body of Shankar, which is like a bow, is just like a ship in the ocean-like world. One who has taken support of that ship or has caught hold of it will go across this ocean-like world. And one who catches hold of some other small boat is about the other religious fathers who are the creators of divisions in this world. Noah, the one who takes his family to the other side of the river, to heaven, is called Agni, the Jatavedas, meaning the one born from fire of wisdom. He is called the sacred authority in an ancient Jewish scripture. He is called Agni, as mentioned in these Gita and Rig Veda verses. Please see series 3 for world pictorial evidences and references from the ancient Abrahamic scripture, the Jewish Tanakh, from which the Bible and Quran have descended. The rainbow as a covenant from God. The covenant meaning pledge or the bond. Seven colors. The rainbow that appears after the rain of knowledge received from Adam, God the Almighty. The seven colors are the seven religions of hell, namely Islam, Buddhism, Christianity, Sannyasa, Muslim, Sikhism, and Arya Samaj. These seven religions are the seven kingdoms who are crushed by Adam. He destroys the intellect of these seven religious fathers and makes them pledge through the reign of knowledge. After receiving the reign of knowledge, they shine up in the sky. This is the rainbow as a covenant from God. This verse from Genesis mentions, this is the history of Noah. Noah was a righteous man. He proved himself faultless among his contemporaries. Noah walked with the true God. In time, Noah became father to three sons, Shem, Ham, and Yepeth. But the earth had become ruined in the sight of the true God, and the earth was filled with violence. Yes, God looked upon the earth and it was ruined. All flesh had ruined its way on the earth. Noah is the perfected or righteous Adam, the Adi Manu, as said in Gita verse 1 of chapter 4. All flesh had ruined means the body consciousness, the Paradharma, the Adharma, the unrighteousness, or the false human ignorance ruined the earth at the end of the Iron Age, hence appropriately named for the intellects of all people becoming rusted iron-like. Noah walked with the true God as nothing but the Adam, who is the temple of Yehovah, meaning the two souls in one body, is the only begotten son of Yehovah who became in the image of God. And the same mentions here, as Noah proved himself faultless among his contemporaries and he walked with the true God. We see Jean Matlock's book, Jesus and Moses are Buried in India, the page 18 and 20. The screenshot is pasted here, which mentions Noah's story is taken from Hindu mythology, Matsya Purana, the Fish Chronicle. Noah in Hinduism is called Adi Manu, meaning the first raised corporeal personality, the father of all humans, the perfected Adam. We request the viewers to watch the three series and the episodes within the series in the numbered sequence. We have used questioning technique where each and every point is questioned, answered in the most practical manner, supported by religious scriptural references and other authentic evidences, and thus are arranged in logically meaningful flow.